I really am honored to be able to speak to what I think is the kickoff, most important messages of the workshop, and that's the outcomes. And we really, we may have started as a thinkers group, which sounded awfully pretentious, and we kind of laughed at ourselves around that and tried to get away from that and that kind of stuff. And where we landed in what I think is a really good place was starting to talk about it as an outcomes proposal. So this workshop really is something that emerged out of what we call the outcomes proposal. And importantly, it's about getting to a place of action. And I know when Ian stopped me in the hall in Leavenworth as I was heading back to Olympia, and he says, you know, John, we gotta do something beyond what we just talked about. You know, we were talking about moving away from just collaborating on our science and getting our science in order, to saying, well, why don't we need to act on the science that we have. And a few weeks later, a month later, I don't know what it was, Leon had crafted together a first cut white paper, if you will, of trying to describe what that would look like and what that mission would be, and that led us to an actual proposal that we gave to the steering committee for their blessing and funding to allow for this workshop and the development of the workshop. But most importantly, it is about the workshop outcome. This workshop is about outcomes. And that's the thing I want you to take away from this introductory session and into the different parts of the workshop, and keep that in mind. And as well, we're trying to go with this, and it's going to be a series of steps that we go over the next 2 days, starting with what we think are some fairly basic kind of pieces that we need to build on from one step to the next to finally get to that place of where maybe it'll all kind of make sense at the end. But if you're thinking about that, and if you're lucky, maybe it'll make sense even earlier. So obviously, we want to really, as an outcome, we really want to you all to know and be able to go back to your work environments and the people you work with, is to learn how to bring connectivity into your planning environment. So we're hoping there's an education part of this workshop for you to be able to take that back and figure out how you bring connectivity. And as Tom so well put, many of you are really kind of already there and know how to do that. But as a group, I think there's a lot of group energy that can emerge that can help us tackle that big challenge, which is getting attention and activity and action toward conservation of connectivity areas. And as well for that, we want to identify, you know, the information gaps. We want to come away with the workshop with an understanding of what don't we know. As I mentioned, the first kind of premise of developing this outcomes proposal was, you know, what do we know, and what can we do with what we know now, and how do we move that into action? But we know we don't know everything. There's a lot we don't know, and we're hoping that through the process of the next 2 days, we're going to really be able to more elucidate what those areas are and help us in the future guide us to where our next steps are. The third outcome, and this is written more as for me as an objective, but for me, the outcome is that we results in action. And a process, how we're going to do that is through recommendations to the steering committee of what needs to be done. But really, the outcome that we want to have as a result of this workshop is we want these recommendations to get into action. The steering committee is one way to do that. And although we've maybe emphasized that as a major part of what we're trying to do, I want to speak to you all as the audience of what we're trying to move into action. And so it isn't just about going back to the steering committee and asking them to kind of bless things and move things forward. We're hoping this also will move you and the organizations that you work with and the people that you work with back when you go back, and you'll find a way and a place in, throughout this 2 days to help identify, help clarify, help focus where you can make a difference as you go home outside of the workshop. So the outcome is not just about recommendations to the steering committee, but it's about moving into action. And of course, finally, helping us figure out, okay, so what are those next steps, and for the players in this room, and to the steering committee, and the players that aren't in this room, like the ones who might be watching the video that we're taping here. So you might think of the common questions of who, what, where, why, how. So the who in that kind of string is you all, right? And the people you work with. The where in this context is the Great Northern landscape. The how, we just heard Tom, the how is going to be what we do here in the mechanisms that we go through today and tomorrow to determine how we're going to achieve the outcomes, the what that we are identified here. And the why, Tom went through very clearly about why it is, why do we need to be doing this, and that kind of thing. So the first day, we're going to kind of use workshop sessions, and you'll see this, I'll go into the workflow of the agenda here in a minute, where we're going to really kind of want to end up at the end of the first day with defining landscape connection, priority areas within the Great Northern, the whole Great Northern, and we'll kind of work our way through from north to south, or middle to end, or however we want to do it. Who are the players in the Great Northern, in the different areas of the Great Northern, the partnerships, the jurisdictions, so we'll have a better understanding of the who as a result of this first day. And then when we look at the maps and identify the what our current knowledge is, we'll be able to identify where and who is in these areas that can affect change and implement connectivity kind of strategies and that kind of stuff. So the first workshop I want to emphasize is really about the where, which is a culmination of all really hard work that Meredith and her team did, and we're going to hear a lot more detail on that following me, about the science. So kind of back to, well, what do we know, where do we know it, and what can we do now about it? So we want that first session that you're going to break out into to really focus on the current knowledge and helping us identify the wares that we need to look for opportunities and challenges for related to connectivity. And when we're done, we'll have identified these landscape and institutional opportunities to address those priority connections. So then day two is all about kind of getting to the strategies and actions. And this is where we'll really focus in on the work that we had done on the first day in identifying, well, what can we do about it? What in each of these areas that we identify on the first day? And we may find that we'll identify some new areas in the second day that we didn't identify on the first day. That'll be part of the process. But really focus on figuring out and evaluating the different stressors, opportunities, and challenges in each of the areas, and what are the appropriate priority actions that would be useful to address connectivity in the various areas. So that when we're done with the end of the second day, this is kind of the big goal here, is having a real kind of as clear as we can across the Great Northern, Tom said, a huge landscape, but kind of the beginning of a work plan of action that would identify what the key strategies are, who the key players are in the various areas of the Great Northern, and what the priorities for actions are that we can all work toward in some cohesive, shared vision way to achieve our goals. All right, so a little bit of detail, borrowing slides from Scott. on how this is going to work. So we've heard from Scott and Tom and me, as we're going to then move into a presentation by Meredith, Dave, and Tabitha. We're going to kind of pass the baton back and forth as they talk about what do we know and where do we know it. And that's going to feed into the first session. After we'll take a little break that will then go into the what I mentioned about, we'll be looking at the data, looking at the information that, and exploring the maps that you see around on the wall. I think, I don't know if Matt got credit due for all the work he's done in generating the maps, and Meredith, okay, in producing the maps for us to use and explore where are the areas that we know and have done a lot of work for evaluating important areas for connectivity. You'll see it's not all equal in terms of our knowledge across the range of the landscape of the Great Northern, and where are the gaps? And so that's what the first really workshop is about, is really kind of trying to explore as much as time will allow the information that we have gathered to date. And speaking of, there are better maps. This is a dynamic live process that we will also to be able to take that opportunity to learn if there are additional information that we didn't include and don't have included in the atlas and things, that we can kind of make note of that and get that gathered up so that it'll be compiled into the atlas if at all possible. We're going to have the hosted lunch here in the room after that first workshop session. So we're going to be breaking out into four groups. So you'll see the big tables in the map products around the big tables. Those are what we're going to do in each of these blue boxes. We'll be working together as a team to address the various goals and objectives of the various sessions. And I might mention, did they get the workshop question handouts yet? Okay, so you should have received in each of these workshop sessions, the blue boxes, we'll be going through a series of questions to answer and help, and each of these areas will be facilitated and note-taking and to answer those questions as we go through that. So you'll stay in the same group on the first day as we come back from break, as we come back from lunch, and after the case studies that we'll hear in the afternoon again, go through those workshop questions and try to get to the goals and objectives of each of those sessions. That'll move us in. Oh, then there will be some more information. There is a dinner and a guest speaker that evening tonight that we'll have more logistic details on at the end of the day today. Then tomorrow, I don't know why I get these morning 8 o'clock starts, you know, this is not my best time. But, so the evening I do quite well in, though. I'm going to kind of be back up here again just to kind of get us back on point, remind us what our charge is, maybe be able to do a little bit of assessment of what happened the day before, we'll see. And but mostly focus on getting us all charged up and ready to go for the day ahead of us. I mean, the agenda is quite full. We understand that and really appreciate your attention and ability to hang in there with us and make something of this workshop. Ian's going to do his inspirational work following me and really talk about, you know, what inspired him, I think, and really helping us get this workshop going and talk about, you know, what the role is, what our role is for action. We'll then break into a new set of work groups. I missed how we're going to know what group you are assigned to. What's that?
The second day.
How about the first day? All right, so go. So when we get time to break out, sorry about that, but when it gets time to break out into groups, go, if you haven't already, find yourself on the wall. There's a list of names, and the next day you'll be in a different group, and the second day those groups are going to be more aligned to geographic region of where you're from, because we're really wanting to get into some of the more real details of what's going on in that geographic region that we've talked about. And you'll have better knowledge in those areas when you're in the group for that geographic region. The first day we created work groups that are really cross geographic regions, because we want to start with thinking of the whole landscape, the broad landscape as a whole, and being able to think beyond just your world and to be able to start connecting to the larger landscape. I mean, this whole workshop is not just about outcomes specifically, but it's also about connecting to the larger landscape, to the larger conservation community that's part of that landscape, who we all are. And so we want this first day to really be a mix, as your groups to be a mix of folks beyond for different geographic areas to help facilitate that conversation that gets you into thinking about the entire Great Northern as a whole. So the details are, there's more, you know, you can look at the agenda. And I think you'll get a lot out of the workshop questions when you read. I encourage you to kind of read through those and prepare yourself for thinking about what each workshop is about, so you can help the facilitator stay on track, help the group stay on track, and make sure you're really addressing, because the time is going to go by pretty short for some of the breakouts in particular. And so we really need to stay focused, and to do that, it would be good for you to kind of know what that particular session is about, and the details on the worksheets really give you good information around that. The questions kind of tip our hand as to what it is we're really trying to get out of that workshop session. So the last workshop session really is kind of, so you know, the place where we try to bring it all home, and not just because it's a lot of words, but it's the big box, because that's really what we're trying to get to, and it's bringing information that we've done in the previous five sessions into this last sixth session to really kind of get to this work plan throughout the Great Northern, and identify in the different areas what are the priorities, who are the major partners, what are the needs. And we may find that in some areas partnerships are really strong. Well, we know that's true. And in other areas partnerships might be a little weaker, and I'm talking about more of the collaborative element that conservation actions might be develop partnerships and really focus on that, building that partnership and building that collaboration. In other areas where the science is really strong and we have it, the priority actions might be, you know, get in there and establish agreements with landowners or something like that. So really a wide range of strategies that I expect to emerge depending on where we're at in the landscape. And in the end, this last workshop is where we kind of really get it down and on a piece of paper and start organizing it, so we can kind of start seeing that what that work plan would look like. And then after the break, we'll kind of have our final wrap-up session. And I think, to be fair, we're really kind of open on how this is going to go. So we're not sure exactly how we're going to do this yet. Who's going to do it? We know we need it. And so we're kind of going to wait and see how it develops in terms of where we want to go. We definitely want some sort of a report out of the work groups and what they came with. We want to definitely get to feedback on you all on how you were thinking this workshop went, and what, you know, any thoughts you might have. And we want to, so we want to be able to make that happen, and depending on how much, what the time looks like and the energy, I guess is why we're a little bit up in the air and how we're going to finalize that last step. But that's what a workshop's about, right?